MasterCAM, in this video, we discuss about one of the most using operation in the lathe CNY axis toolpath. That operation is known as cross contour. Cross contour is basically used for creating that kind of slots. So in this video, we will discuss about each and every single parameter of cross contour, that how we can prepare that kind of part. Let me show you that part in the 3D. So that part is I am already made. If there is any on your part, there is any that kind of slots that you have to create. So you can use cross contour toolpath on the CNC lathe C and Y axis. So in this video, we will discuss about each and every single parameter of lathe C and Y axis toolpath of cross contour. So first, let me delete the both of the toolpath which I already done. Delete, and now yes. So okay, let me discuss about that how we can prepare for a lathe cross contour toolpath. For creating lathe cross contour toolpath, first we have to select the operation. So first I click on the operation. Now there is a one dialog box open. I have to select chain, on which one chain I have to machining. So for this part, let me show you once drawing so you can understanding easily. This is the drawing for this part, and we have to create that one slot, and the slot width is, as you can see, 10 mm, and then you can also download that one drawing for the practice purpose. So this is the slot which width is 10 mm, and we have a one line from the center of that slot. So now for creating a slots, we have to come in the cross contour toolpath, and now we select the chain. So we can just select that one chain from the center of that one area. Now we click OK. Now we have to select tool. As you know, that the width of the width is still 10 mm, so we choose 10 mm flat end mill. Now what is the feed rate? Feed rate is here also, and what is the spindle speed? Now we can input in the comment, we can input here C axis cross contour. Now the next one parameter is cutting parameter, which is mostly usually cutting parameter. In this operation, we are selecting a center line where we have to create a slot. So in the compensation, must sure we have to make off, and a contour type, it should be 2D contour. Now the next one is the depth of cut. Depth of cut means what is the depth of for the each pass. So now here we are inputting the depth of cut for the rough pass 0.2, and the last and final or a finish pass, its depth is 0.1. And how many passes for the finishing? It's required a one cut pass. Now here we are coming in the lead in and lead out. We have to also input what is the lead in and lead out value. When we are working on the C axis cross contour, so in a lead in and lead out, we have to selecting the tangent as per line. Tangent means, so lead out, lead in will be from this line to continuously extending from this one line. And for lead out also, when we are making tangent, so this line will be continuously extend. Now here in the breakthrough, there is nothing to, we have to input multi passes, nothing. Now we are coming in the cutting parameter. In the cutting parameter, must sure now we are selecting that one line for the creating that toolpath. So now when we press OK, so that time there is a one toolpath, as you can see. Now what we have to change is, we just have to make toolpath. Now we are coming in the cutting parameter. In the cutting parameter, what we have to do, we can provide the input value from the selection line to the what is the top stock. So we can input the value is 6 mm stock from the selection line. Now we press OK and regenerating the toolpath. So as you can see here, our toolpath is done, and the toolpath is generated. Let me show you in the 2D simulation. So as you can see in the 2D simulation, our toolpath is done, and the tool is cutting a slot. And when the tool is coming to cut So that time it is not plunging on the workpiece material. So now we are creating only a single slot, as you can see. Now we have to also create, there are three numbers of slot. So what we have to do, we make a some trick. So what we have to do, we can rotate the toolpath from the three different places. For select rotating the toolpath, we have to select toolpath transform. Now we make a toolpath transform. So you will also understanding about how we can make toolpath transform. So first we have to select rotate. Rotate means we in the toolpath transform you can choose different method. So now here we have to rotate. So we select a rotate. And now what is the method of rotation? We have to rotate according to tool plane. Include origin. It means it will be rotating from the x0 and z0. Now source, what we have to rotate? NCI. NCI means key over that G code and M code. So we have to select NCI. And now the next one option is group NCI output. Group F, it means key that NCI means key G code and M code will be generated in a continuously group. So now we have to just select that our operation which we have to rotate. Now we are coming on the next one parameter, which is the rotate. Here in a rotate, what is the number of rotation required? It is 3 because one operation we already done. And now what is the angle of rotation? It is 90 degree from the first operation. Now we have to also selecting what is the operation of the rotating plane of the operation. So we make a box mark, and here we have to selection the plane of the rotation. Now here make sure if we are rotating that one from the top plane, so it, now it is rotating in a different type. So what we have to do, we can rotate that one toolpath from the front plane. And now okay, so now as you can see our all toolpaths are done, and we can perform that one program. That one is over first toolpath, and that one is over other three toolpath. You can also simulate that one toolpath easily. If there is any query, you can contact us. I wish you got all the parameters and all the detail about that how we can prepare cross-contour toolpath. So thank you.